power is equals to 1 upon focal length. And we also studied that focal length should be in meter for always. Okay, 10 meter, 5 meter, okay. It is possible that focal length which is provided to you in numerical can be in centimeters, okay? Most probably it is in centimeters. So you have to convert it. So this is the power. And now we are going to do some numericals. Before doing numericals, we will study that we know what is power. Power is the ability of convergence and divergence of the lenses. We know this. Convergence for this type of lens and divergence for this type of lens. Okay. Now, if it is focal length is given to you in plus, in numericals, you will be given with V, U, P or so many things. If the focal length is given to you in plus, you know, we know that this 50% is always positive. We know that. Okay. So, if focal length is given to you in positive diopter, okay, that is, if it is given in positive focal length, okay, focal length. Okay, small f. If it is given like 10, 12, 1.25, okay, whatever. So it means that if it is focal positive focal length, then that it means that we are talking about convergence or divergence, convergence, and we are talking about convex lens. Okay, so positive goes with convex. Okay, it is possible that you could be given with power. Okay, so it is given in positive and it is given in power or in diopter. Okay, like there is a lens whose power is 10 diopter. Okay, there is a lens which whose power is 12 diopter. There is a lens whose power is 1.25 diopter. Okay, so diopter is a sign of power. It means that if you are given with diopter, 1 diopter, 2 diopter, 1.5 diopter, whatever, it means that the questioner is asking you about power. Okay, so power measured in diopter, 2 diopter, 4 diopter, 5 diopter, 6 diopter, diopter. Okay, so if it is given in plus, plus 4, plus 5, plus 6, it also means that we are talking about convex lens. Okay, so if the focal length is given in plus, for sure, or if the power is given in plus, okay, power will be given in diopter. Okay, you can be directly asked that the power is 2 diopter, or you can be asked that 2 diopter, okay, or focal length. Okay, we know the relationship. This is the relationship. P is equals to 1 by F, or F is equals to 1 by P. That is the relationship. Okay, you can, in these type of questions, you could be asked with to find the power or to find the focal length. Okay, whatever happened. But if the things are in positive, okay, 16, whatever, okay, then we are talking about convex lens, remember. And if the things are given in negative, that means the focal length which is given to you in negative, they will not ask you that the focal length I'm giving you, we are going to talk about the concave lens. They will just say that the focal length is in negative way. So we know that this is the less 50%, okay, and it is always negative for both, for here and here, the focal length will be considered as negative. So 10, 12, 2.3, 2.25, whatever, okay. So if the focal length is given in negative, that means they are talking about concave lens. And if the power is also given in negative, like power can be like 14 or 2 or 1.5, okay, so it will be always negative. Okay, so it means they are talking about these type of lenses. So if you find the sign of negative, then you are, the examiner is talking about this type of lens, that is contour lens. And the, if you find the sign which is positive for both power and focal length, then the examiner is talking about this type of lenses, that is convex. Okay, this one thing. Next thing, that generally, I want to make a lens of 2.5 diopter. Okay, I want to make a lens of plus 2.5 diopter. This is my requirement. I want to make a create a lens, or I want to make something which power is, whose power is 2.5 diopter. Okay, this is diopter. Okay, now what should I do? Instead of taking one lens which is having the power of 2.5, what is the power? The ability of convergence. Okay, instead of taking one lens, I would prefer to take two lenses. Okay, one lens which is having power of 2 diopter and another lens which is having power of 0.5 diopter. Okay, so it will form 2 plus 0.5 is equals to 2.5. Okay, so I will prefer taking two lenses rather than one lens. Okay, or I will prefer taking three lenses. One diopter plus 1 diopter plus 0.5 diopter, that is 2.5 diopter. I will prefer taking more lenses rather than taking a single lens whose power is directly 2.5 diopter. Same thing goes with these type of lenses. I want something like 5.5 diopter. Okay, definitely it will be in minus because this is a less 20%, this is a concave lens. So instead of taking a single lens which is having the power of minus 5.5 diopter, I would like, or I will prefer, okay, generally we prefer to take so many lenses, like one is with a minus 5 diopter and one is 0.5 diopter, so it will form 5.5 diopter. Okay, instead of this, I can take 3 diopter, 2 diopter. Okay, the power of divergence. Okay, I will take the lenses which are having the power of divergence. That is the power. Okay, the power of divergence is known as the capacity of divergence, because these type of lens go for divergence. So 2 diopter plus 0.5 diopter. Okay, definitely minus. I will take 3 lenses. Okay, 3. Okay, 3 lenses, and it will form 5 diopter. Okay, why I'm doing this? Instead of taking one lens, which will be easier for me, I want to make something. Sometimes, no, we use, sometimes we need to produce a particular length of a particular power. And instead of making this, okay, these things happen generally in telescopes, okay, when we use more than two lenses. So instead of doing this, or we generally need to use so many apparatus like microscope and so many other things. So binoculars, okay, there are so many things. So instead of taking one lens, okay, we just prefer to take more than two lenses, okay, more than one lens, because it gives much accuracy. Accuracy, okay, it is very perfect, or it will give more accuracy, more accurate values. So that's why we prefer taking more lenses rather than a single one lens, because it gives us more accuracy and very appropriate things. Okay, so this is done, and now we are going to do some numericals. Okay, so I will not go for so many numericals. We will just do two or three numericals, and after that we will move on to another chapter, that is the chapter 1, chemical reactions, after this. So hopefully you are done with your formulas. Okay, we are going to do numericals based on lenses. Okay, first of all, I'm writing a question here. I'm taking a random question. Okay, a concave lens has focal length of 15 centimeter. Write with me, because you have to do the calculations. A concave lens has focal length. Okay, focal length. So I'm writing this directly. Focal length. Okay. Focal length of 15 centimeter. I told you that you will be given focal length in centimeters and you have to convert this in meters. Okay. But right now, we are not going to convert it because we are not calculating the power. Okay, I will tell you. We will not calculate the power. At what distance? At what distance should the object that is you, okay, from the lens be placed so that it forms an image that is V at 10 centimeter from the lens. Okay, and after all we have to find out the magnification also. Okay, magnification. Now this is my question. What should I do? First of all, in these type of question, first of all, let's talk about that which type of lens is using here. Okay, what type of lens is this? So it says me that I'm using concave lens. Now draw a concave lens. First of all, draw this. Okay, draw this very smoothly. After that, just draw these four focuses, that is F1, 2F1, F1. No, sorry, I just wrote something not correct. This is F. This side is F2. F2. Okay. 2F2. Okay, this is focus. Okay, this is focus. This is not a focal length. And this is known as F1. And this is known as 2F1. And this is also known as C point. And this is known as C point. This is C2. And this is C1. Okay. We will, first of all, we should do this. After doing this, we will do what extra we need to do. Okay, this is optical center. Okay, first of all, this concave lens. Now, we have to write the initials, what is given to us and what should we find. Okay, so at what distance should the object U from the lens be placed? So, we have to find U. Okay, we have to find U. Okay, so we will have to find you. I don't know where it should be placed. Okay, and from the lens so that it forms the image V at 10 centimeter from the lens. So images, that is image. Okay, so it is at 10 centimeter. So it is present. It is definitely present at 10 centimeter. Now, if you remember these type of lenses, you know that these type of concave lenses are forming images always and always and always at left side. We know this, that these type of lenses are forming images at left side. We know this because we only studied two type of image formation, and this image formation is taking place at left side. We studied this. Now, can you tell me that if this type of lens is forming image at left side, what should be the property of this type of image? I told you the equation or theory that if you talk about lenses, okay, then the image is forming, what are the properties? Virtual, okay, and erect. Okay, virtual and erect. Remember this, that if lenses are forming image, okay, these type of lens, this is concave lens and it is always forming image at left side. This is the very true thing. This is the very perfect thing for lenses. That concave lens is forming image at left side for sure. Okay, it will not produce any image at right. and the image should be virtual and erect. So I'm very sure about one thing, that my image is virtual and erect and it is forming at this side. Okay, so the image is forming at this side at 10 centimeter. Okay, and let's see if I am provided with the focal length. So no, I'm not provided with focal length. There is no focal length. There is focal length. Yeah, this is 15. Okay, so there is 15 centimeter. Write down. This is 15 centimeter. Again, this is 15 centimeter, this distance. Okay, again, this is 15 centimeter. This distance is also 15 centimeter and this distance is also 15 centimeter. If one focal length is 15 centimeter, then others will be definitely 15. Okay, now I have one thing, that is F, and that is 15. Okay, now one thing I told you about these type of lenses, that this thing that is less fatty thing is having negative signs and on both sides. We studied this, that if you are provided with F or if you are provided with D, okay, focal length or D, for these type of lenses, they will ask you in minus. Okay, adapter will be all, power will be in negative of these type of lenses and the focal length will be always negative for both, for this side, for left side or for right side, because it is decreasing the something, this part is, there is no part. Okay, so the focal length will be considered as minus negative. Okay, for this. Okay, focal length never follows. We studied this on yesterday, that for lenses, there is no direction for focal length. We studied this. It will be negative for concave and it will be positive for convex for both left and right side. Okay, now the image is forming here. I know the image is forming at left side and the general rule for left side, that it will be minus. Okay, for general rule, left side will be minus. For V and U, and right side will be plus. There is no image formation at right side. So everything which will come is of minus. Okay. So my image is forming exactly at 10 centimeter, means that if this is the 15, this is the 15, this is exact 15, we know. One thing I'm very sure, that this distance is 15. This distance from optical center to F1 is 15. For F1 to 2F1 is 15. From optical center to F2 is 15 and F2 to 2F2 is also 15. So image is forming at 10 centimeter definitely. And in these type of lenses, image is forming at left side and it is virtual. I know one thing, okay, that virtual and erect, very short thing. Okay, so this helps me a lot. And if you don't learn this, then you will not be able to find answers. Okay, so this distance is 15, I know. Okay. So I will, okay, this exact distance, okay, this is 15, exact this is 15, exactly this is 15, okay. I did so much mess. Okay, this is the exact 15 from optical center. We know this, okay, I'm just make you understand, okay. So this is the distance, that is 15. So it will be, I think, good to draw 10 centimeter. I am drawing 10 centimeter here. Okay, so there is my image, that is my V. Okay, now if you having your NCRT, then it's very okay. And if you are not having your NCRT, just bring it. I'm giving you 20 seconds. If you are having this, it's okay. And if you are not having this, it's okay. Just bring it. Okay, both of you are having your NCRT, because you will answer me. Okay, doesn't matter, bring your NCRT quickly, because okay, now tell me, look at the page number 181, the page number 181, figure number 10.7. Page number 181 and figure number 10.17. Okay, where is my image? My image, okay, and figure number B. in figure number 10.7, look at B. Okay, B. Look at B. Look at B. Okay, look at B. Page number 181, figure number 10.17, and the B part. Okay. The image is between O optical center and F1, isn't it? Can you see this? That in this diagram, the image is forming between F1 and optical center. Can you see this? Can you relate this? It is written as B, okay, in our book. It says B is image. Can you see this? Okay, can you see this? I just want to know that, can you relate this diagram that my image is placing between F1 and O, and you can see the diagram, figure 10.17 and the part B. You can see this. Okay, so my image is between these F1 and O. Faizan, can you see this, Peter? Can you relate this from your book? I can relate this diagram from our NCERT. Okay. Now the answer is ours. Okay. What should I do? Just draw a diagram, that is B diagram. That is the exact diagram from your book. Okay. So I'm going to draw the diagram. This. Because I know that which diagram is exactly. This is the B diagram from my NCERT. Okay, this is the diagram I'm going to draw right now, the diagram that is 10.17 part B, because one thing which is very, I found it, that, what did I found? I found that my image is between F1 and O, that is my location of the image, and I'm going to draw this image exactly. Okay, now first of all, this is optical center. Draw this thing. Okay, so where is my object should be? My object should be between two F1 and F1. Maybe it is between two F1 or F1, or maybe it is at infinity. Okay, it is present at infinity. My object, okay, because I know about this. I know I have to draw this according to this diagram. Okay, so if I check the table number 10.5, then I will see the lower thing, that if my image is forming here, my image is forming somewhere here for sure. Okay, so my object should be at infinity. So you can draw this according to your book, or you can draw something here. Okay, infinity means just between O and infinity, between O and infinity. Okay, so I'm drawing this here. You can draw this away from 2F1, or you can draw this between F1 and 2F1, whatever you want. So we are just following our NCERT, and I'm going to draw this between F1 and 2F1. I'm just going to draw the same diagram. Okay, now draw the same diagram. These are the returning rays. Okay, and the second ray is okay. So this is the formation of image. Okay, this is my image formation, and this is my B. Okay, now this is my u. Okay, I have to find out what is u. So let's find out the u. Okay, so let's find out the u. First of all, whatever I need to do, I will do everything in this diagram, particularly in this diagram. Okay, I'm just removing this long line because I will write the u. Where is u? So my b is exactly 10 centimeter. Okay, that is 10 centimeter from this is okay, and my focal length is exactly 15 centimeter, which is given to me. Okay, this is. Okay, I can write focal length is small f. Okay, so this is the focal length. Okay, which is focal length is from optical center to principal focus. Okay, so there are four principal focuses and there are four focal lengths. Okay, this is focal length, this is focal length. Okay, we don't need to write this always. I know this, that the distance from optical center to principal focus, there are four principal focuses, F2, 2F2, F1 and 2F1. Okay, that is 15. It is understandable thing. Now I have to find out the value of U. What is U and exactly where U is located? So I have to find out U. Okay, any one of you, can you suggest me in the mirror formula? What should I use? What formula I should use? I have to find out U. Okay. So I have some values. I don't have u. Okay, I have v, and if it is in this direction, okay, it will be in minus. So I have v, that is minus 10 centimeter. I have, yes, Thalia, very good. Now I have focal length, which is provided to me according to book, that is minus 15 centimeter. Okay, it is not minus because it is at left side. It is minus because this lens goes with focal length of minus. Okay, it should, if it is in this direction, it should be minus because the lens, this type of lens is having negative focal length. Okay, now my mirror formula, what is my mirror formula? No, sorry, lens formula. My lens formula is 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equals to 1 upon f. So I need to find out the u definitely. So I will find out u. So this is 1 upon v minus 1 upon f. Okay, now you can calculate it, and you are definitely not depending upon me to calculate this. Okay, what is the value of v? This is minus 10. Okay, just try to avoid writing centimeter and that's here. Okay, we will finish this on last. And what is the F? Okay, this minus comes from this formula, and this minus comes because the V is having negative sign. Okay, because image is forming at left side. In lenses, only two things, U and V, only two things, U and V will follow the side, either it is left side or right side. Okay, only U and V. And in lenses, F will not follow the side rule. It will be positive for convex lens and it will be negative for concave lens. That's why it is negative, okay? It is negative here, not because of its direction, but because of this lens. Now, I think it took so much time, but at least I have to show you one example. Okay, now that is minus 15. Okay, now beta, both of you are able to do this. Okay, I think you have to take LCM and after that you have to do this. I'm giving you 2 minutes, 3 minutes, just give me the final calculation. What is 1 upon u? What will be 1 upon u? Please give me the answer. Okay, I need answer in numerator and denominator with proper signs. Don't mess up with these signs. Okay, you know this. Okay, do this and give me the answer. Yes, very good. Salia, give me correct answer. Faizan, I'm waiting for you. Yeah, both of you give me correct answer. Very good. Okay, very, very good. Okay, both of you are correct. Now, I want you. I don't want one by you. Okay, so I will just reciprocate this and I will just go with this. Okay, there is no value of one. I will just cancel out this and my u is minus 30. What I obtained that in this diagram, okay, in this diagram, I made my diagram, okay, but the u is at 30. That means from optical center to u, from optical center to u is 30 and it is in minus, okay. We are getting this in minus. We are getting this is minus, and one more thing, we know that V and U in lenses always follow the rule of direction. So it is forming at left side. Obviously, you give me this answer. You give me this answer. Where is my numerical? Yeah. You gave me this answer. It is in negative. Okay, that means it should be forming at left side, and very sure we draw this, okay, from our book, and we know that the U is forming at left side, okay, and V and U always follow the rule of direction for lenses. Definitely F is not following, but U and V is following, and it is having U side. So it is either you should write minus in front of it or not write it. It is considerable that it is at left side, then it should be in minus, okay. So we obtain U in minus, okay. So my answer that U is minus 30 centimeter, and I have drawn this. So it is possible that before you identify this, okay, it is possible that first of all you identify this and you will draw the diagram after this. Okay, it is okay that first of all I don't want to draw this diagram and I want to identify my U first. It's okay. Okay. And another thing is also okay that if you are very intelligent and if you know that which type of diagram it is forming and if the image is forming here, then where the object should be placed. If you know this, then you can draw the diagram before calculating U. You have to find out U because it is a question. Okay, you have to find it. You can find out U before drawing this diagram, or you can find out U after drawing this diagram. But I don't know that what is the exact distance. That's why I didn't write this, and now I know this, I will write this. So my U is 30 minus 30, okay, which I have to find it out, and I found out this, and my F1, which is given to me, was minus 15. It was given to me, and my V was also given to me, that was minus 10. Okay, you can do this. Now we have to find out the magnification and those things. Okay, so there is a formula of magnification. Zalia, can you write me the formula of magnification for lenses? Just formula. Okay, don't write all the details. Just write me the formula. Yeah. So, M is equals to height of object upon height of image upon height of object. So we can write this h hash upon h, and it was also plus v upon u. Okay, this was the formula. It is asking me to write this. Okay, so I having two things. I'm not having the height of object and height of image. Okay, I'm not having this. You can be provided with this by examiner, but right now I'm having only two values. So I will write this v. What was my v? My v was, let's see, let's check out back. That is minus 10. And my U was minus 30. Okay, so that is 1/3. Okay, minus minus will go cancel out. So magnification was 1/3, and magnification was 0.33. Okay, it will be 0.33. Okay, and it will be in plus. Okay, the plus signs means that the image which is forming the object. Okay, magnification doesn't have any unit. Okay, so the magnification, what I have to find out, so magnification of the lens, the image is forming. Okay, magnification means the magnification will happen with image, not with object. Remember this, that the you are not going to find out the magnification object. No, you are going to find out each and every time. Okay, we are going to understand about the size or the magnification of image. Remember that it is diminished, highly diminished, same size, enlarged, whatever. Okay, so remember one thing, that the magnification relates with image, not with object. Remember this, magnification, we are going to find out, or we will find out the magnification of image. Remember this. Okay, sometimes there is very confusion in this chapter. Remember, our book also says this. Our book is not going to tell the magnification of object. Okay, it is telling us that magnification of image, either it can be very same size, it can be increased, it can be decreased. Okay, so the object is, if I consider that my object is 1 centimeter, then my image is 0.33 centimeter. So it will be lesser. This was my object and this is my image. Okay, and the plus sign indicates that it will be erect. That means it will be at this side. Okay, inverted means this side. Okay, so it will be erect for sure. That is at this side, this is erect. Okay, and it is smaller in size, it is diminished. Okay, why diminished? Because it is 0.33. okay, ratio wise. So 0.33 means that if I am considering my object as 1 centimeter, then my image is 0.33 centimeter. Okay, so we in each and every type of question of mirrors and lenses, either the question are having very difficult words or sometimes it's make you confused, then remember one thing, that we each and every time we have to find out the magnification and the position of image and not object. Remember this. Okay, so in this diagram we have drawn this. Okay, what happens, that is the image. Obviously image was given us previously and we have to find out the distance of this object. Okay, obviously, but for magnification I have to tell that, okay, it's possible that I have to find out object and image was given us previously. It doesn't matter. Okay, it is in erect direction. That means it is this size and it is comparatively less. So you can see. Okay, so it is object is, if I consider object as 1 centimeter, then my image is comparatively 0.33 centimeter. Okay, am I clear to you? We will be back after 20 seconds. Zoom.